Hello and welcome back to the World of Warcraft Legion beta servers. Today we will be taking a look at the Resto Druid spec and taking a look at their artifact quest, their artifact weapon, class hall, talents, abilities, and some of their animations to see if anything has changed. Before we start, I do want to point out I am on a template character, so my gear is item level 680, so your gear may be much, much better. You may have a different experience while doing this this quest line. I also want to point out a few things as well before we get started. I want to show you some of the talent or passives we have available for Resto, so you understand some of the things that happen. We have Astral Influence, which increases the range of all our abilities by 5 yards. Living Seed, when you critically heal a target with the direct healing portion of Swift Mend, Regrowth, or Healing Touch, you plant a Living Seed on the target. When the target is next attacked, the Living Seed will bloom and heal the target for 50% of the initial heal, and this lasts for 15 seconds. Our Mastery is Harmony. Your healing is increased by 9% over for each of your Restoration Heal over time effects on the target. Omen of Clarity, your healing over time from Life Bloom has a 4% chance to cause a clear casting state, making your next regrowth cost no mana. And finally, Ysera's Gift, healing you for 3% of your maximum health every 5 seconds, and if you are not at full health, a random nearby injured ally will be healed by the passive instead. You will notice something while we are questing. I want to show you a talent so you you know what's going on. There is these new talents here, the Affinity talent, and I have Balance Affinity. So when you see me going to Moonkin form, I'm not actually playing as Moonkin. I have Moonkin Affinity, or Balance Affinity rather, so that I also have that form to be able to do a little bit of extra DPS while I am doing my questing. We did skip all of the opening scenarios and quest lines so that we could get right here to Dalaran in the Broken Isles. And here we go. Ah, it's good to see you on your feet. The members of the Council of Six are recuperating from their ordeal. The intensity of the teleportation spell can be disorienting. It seems you lost consciousness for a time, but at least you didn't awaken to find yourself stuck in a wall. Dalaran has been relocated to the Broken Isles. From here, we will spearhead the effort to acquire the Pillars of Creation and drive the Legion from Azeroth once and for all. When you turn this in, you get your Dalaran Hearthstone, which is essentially your new Garrison Hearthstone, and 5 Tomes of the Tranquil Mind, which are used to respec your talents, whether you are in the open world, dungeons, or raids, as long as you are not in combat.
Be careful.
So make sure you're hanging on to those are very important. We'll throw this on a bar just in case. And as you can see, I don't have any quests available to me on my map or in my quest log. To get your class hall and artifact weapon quest started, just run around Dalaran for a few. I know it sounds kind of silly, but that's exactly what you have to do. This is the new part of Dalaran, by the way, here in the middle. This is the Chamber of the Guardian. And this is probably the only other real change is the statue to Ronin. And maybe the underbelly. Okay, there's our quest.
Greetings. It is fortunate I found you. Your presence is requested at Moonglade.
Your presence is requested at Moonglade at once. We are preparing for a ritual of great importance and will require your assistance. I will meet you there, so please come with haste.
I'll meet you there as soon as you conclude your business in Dalaran.
Let's go ahead and start our teleport to Moonglade and get rolling right away. And here we are, here's Hamelrune Totem. I'm pleased you came on such short notice. We have a great undertaking here in the Moonglade that is about to begin, one in which you will play a key role. Beating the Legion requires us to strike quickly and unexpectedly. We have discovered a dream way by which we could travel through the Emerald Dream itself. Though only a short walk through the dream, it will allow us to cross vast distances of Azeroth and even access the ancient home of the Druids Val'Shirah. Malfurion is preparing the ritual to open the Dreamway. I need you to summon Zhentabra and Narrelex to his side. Only by combining our efforts can we hope to succeed.
Zhentabra's camp is on the western shore of the lake. Narrelex was camped on the eastern shore, but he's prone to wandering off. So keep your eyes and ears open.
So let's go get these two druids. This is where Zentabra will be. You can see there she is right there.
Hey, man. You not be coming to Zentabra for some fish. What you be wanting? There be life all around. Life worth saving. Time to see if we can really be making this happen. This gonna be needing everything we have to give and more. The spirits. They be silent to me on this. That mean they not opposed to it either. Very well. I'll meet you at the ritual.
And now that we have Zentabra on her way, we can go recruit Narilex. Right over here is his little camp. And you have to click on his pillow. And now you can see his scent, which is this little smoke line here. We gotta follow this all the way down and around this big old tree. And here he is.
My life for Kalimdor. This too shall pass.
I'm awake. Definitely not sleeping. I was just resting my eyes. Is it time for the ritual to begin? Very well. I'll meet you there.
Okay, and then once you're done with that, recruiting those two, we'll head back to Hemel Rune Totem, right where we zoned in after our teleport. I mean, you probably could have just teleported to Moonglade again to save a little bit of time. If you're one of those people who are trying to save as much time as possible and finish leveling as fast as possible, you probably could get to Narilex and just cast your teleport again and end up right here.
Nature seeks
good.
Balance.
Soon the ritual will be ready to begin. The preparations for the ritual are now complete. Come with me. I will guide you to the ceremony.
A single thought. Malfurion waits for you by the Barrow Dens to the east. Follow me. The Legion's arrival has thrown our world out of balance. I've sensed great unrest within the Emerald Dream. There are powerful druids in Val Shirah who grew under Cenarius's tutelage after the Great Sundering. Their knowledge of druidism is ancient and unparalleled. Having their might on our side is essential if we are to stop the Legion.
Greetings to you both. The tremors from the Emerald Dream grow more potent. We must begin the ritual at once. The ritual will focus our energy into a portal at the center of the structure. We must keep it stable. Prepare yourself. Step into the circle when you are ready. Excellent. The path is taking form. It grows more stable by the moment. The Dreamway is ready. Good work, everyone.
Now we talk to Malfurion.
How might nature
well done.
Serve.
Now that the path is open, we can begin our journey to Val Shirah. The portal to the Dreamway is open, and it is here where our paths must part. The Moonglade remains vulnerable to the attacks of the Burning Legion, and I must ensure it is well defended. I'm entrusting you with the mission to Val Shirah. Our druid Greathoof is the leader of the druids there. He is wise in the old ways, and will provide us invaluable assistance. The Dreamway can be dangerous, so I will send Keeper Remulos to guide you. Meet with him upon the other side. And we will eventually learn this spell, the Dreamwalk ability, which will take the place of our teleport to Moonglade.
May the winds be at your back.
And we'll step through this portal here. It's hard to see, but just walk forward through there. And here we are, the Emerald Dreamway.
We've arrived. Come, we must find the druids of Val Shirah and request their aid.
No, the nightmare. In this part of the dream? How is it possible? I will cleanse these nightmare vines from our path. Go forth and destroy the source of the corruption that spawned them.
So as you can see, I do have my Moonkin form available. This kind of helps me, and will help you as well, to be able to level more efficiently through this expansion. Nice addition to the talent trees. Everybody in all specs will get a choice of one of the other three specs to be able to kind of help them along, give them an extra side choice. Doesn't quite work as the Moonkin form works, but I mean, obviously it's not going to be as strong as if you were balanced in general, but I find that it's extremely helpful, especially being Resto.
Excellent work. Even now, the foul creep of the nightmare has begun to recede. The way is clear. Come, let us continue to our destination.
So as you can see, in 680 gear,
my vigil,
this part
is eternal.
Is pretty easy, so as long as you're anything over 680, you should have a pretty easy time with this. But this is just our opening quest line. We haven't really gotten on our artifact quest line yet. And if I remember correctly, I did do it earlier, it is a little bit more difficult than this. But that shouldn't be too bad. Anybody that's kind of played Resto should have a good time. So we're going to walk through this portal, and that is going to lead us to some place we're going to spend a good bit of time this expansion.
We made it. Ah, these forests are just as I remember them. An ancient magic protects the dwarf. Here, all brothers and sisters of the wilds will find sanctuary. Come, we must find the druids of Val'Sharah and request their aid.
So, this is the Dream Grove. This is the class hall for druids. If you're looking just to get some ideas of this place, or you're looking for something, look in the description below. I forgot to mention that at the beginning of the video. I do have annotations for times you get skipped to if you just are looking for something in particular. I know these videos can end up being pretty long altogether, so if you're looking for something in particular, just look down below. But this is where we will come back to later on, and I'll talk about some things and give you an idea of what's going
Greetings,
on.
Greetings, Archdruid Greathoof. We have traveled far to seek your aid.
I've heard the land cry out, son of Cenarius. The Legion threatens us all.
Then we must act swiftly and ready the weapons of old for war.
The weapons of old? Yes, they would help indeed. But they are beyond our ability to wield.
There is no one better suited for this task than this champion.
Very well. Your task will not be easy, but I shall do all that I can to aid you. What do you ask of
me? You did well to navigate through the Emerald Dream to get to this place. Still, there are times when you might wish to return here a bit more quickly. This spell will guide you. Traveling the Dreamway is no small feat in itself, but it pales to the tasks ahead. So, you can see, now we have Dreamwalk. It replaced our teleport to the Moonglade. I agree with Keeper Remulos. To confront and defeat the Legion, we will need weapons of legendary power. Among the history of our kind, there have been 4 weapons of renown. Tell me, which weapon would you pursue first?
Go with Cenarius.
So, here's the UI that comes up when we are going to pick our first item to start the expansion. Obviously, we're going to be going with Restoration, Ghanir the Mother Tree. As you can see, it starts at item level 750 and grants an ability that we'll be able to use when we get that far. But there you go, you can take a look at that. Now you can see we have 3 other items, of course, 1 for each of the specs. You will have the option to go back and get the other items at some point during the expansion, the first being 102. I'm not quite sure about the others. Probably 102, 105, and maybe 110, I'm not quite sure. Maybe you could do them all at 102. I know the first one, though, you can do at 102, because I did it on the Demon Hunter that I played at the beginning of the beta. The beta? So, if you were worried about, you know, getting stuck, say you were going to go Restoration, then you go, oh my god, this is so slow, it's so boring, or you just end up hating Restoration, you can go back and get something else and start leveling that up. But let's go ahead and get started here. Thousands of years ago, Aviana gifted the first druids a branch from the Mother Tree Ghanir. It is said that the staff aids the wielder in achieving perfect harmony with nature, allowing them to tap into deeply powerful restorative spells. The branch is kept at a shrine beneath the roots of Shaladrasil, but contact has recently been lost with the druids there.
Do you need my aid?
Excellent choice. With the power of that weapon in your hands, we will be able to bring balance back to Azeroth.
Walk in peace.
May Elun guide your path. How may I aid you?
It would seem we are fortuitous that you seek Ghanir this day. The Dryad Maloon arrived not long ago from the sacred shrine where the staff has been guarded for many centuries. Few are privy to its hidden location within the roots of Shaladrasil, but you have certainly earned that right. Speak to Maloon when you are ready to depart. I saw her last just east of here up the hill.
Good luck.
So, she's right over there. We're going to go talk to the Dryad Maloon, and she will help us get started to go find our restoration staff.
Raspberries! I don't know what to do!
Mylune's eyes are watery with dew, her usual smile an unsightly frown. Yes?
Bye!
Ghanir is... Maloon wipes her eyes, sniffling, corrupted. The nightmare has risen from the depths of the dream. It all happened so fast. I was able to secret the staff here through the dream before it fell fully. It rests for now, but I fear we don't have much time. You must prepare to retrieve Ghanir from the dream. Draw water from the sacred moonwell on the northern edge of the grove, and obtain an ancient's blessing. Quickly, every moment is precious.
Bye!
I kind of hate doing quests with her. So we just head up here. There's a moonwell at the top. Right here, as you can see. There are a couple quests, I think, that come here and have you get some moon water. So go ahead and grab that. Got your cup of the moon water. Here's Leafbeard the Storied. I've watched many of your kind walk the path of life, but none have carried themselves with a stride such as yours. I look forward to telling your story. Of course you may. What pulls you towards the dream with such fervor, Shando? So, he gives us his blessing, and we will head back over to Maloon so that she can tell us how to further proceed. I have done this particular quest line before. I don't remember it bit by bit, but hopefully it's a little easier the second time around.
Our hero will fix this. Just you wait.
Can I...
Are you ready?
...help you?
Maloon's face brightens. Then there is still hope. I'm afraid I can't really help you actually enter the Emerald Dream. We Dryads merely shift our bodies between the planes. That's okay, though. Narolex is offered to help. Go to the very bottom of Talandu Barrow Den. Narolex is already there setting things up for you.
Be careful. It isn't safe in the dream right now.
It is not safe in the dream right now. That is an understatement. So, is this the Talandu Barrow Dens? I think it is. Yes, there we go. We entered the Barrow Den. Let's make our way over to the bottom so that we could talk to Narolex and enter the Emerald Dream. We can see you got some druids sleeping in here. Where is he? He is over here? Yes, he's right down here. Look at his clear water. There we go.
I'm afraid the dream is in a worse state than we thought. I'm awake, for now.
My preparations are complete. Are you prepared to enter the dream?
The balance must be
restored. This bed will
be
yours for the deep slumber that will usher you into the dream. Once you're comfortable, drink the moon water you brought. I will guide you from there. Quickly now. With every passing moment, Gonir slips further into darkness.
Goodbye. You still have the moon water, yes? Good, good. Then you are ready.
So, let's... I don't think you need to step on the platform. You might, but... Here, we're gonna drink our water. Take a nap.
Now just relax and focus your mind on the dream. I will guide your spirit from here.
God, that sounds so rapey. Go ahead, go to sleep, don't worry.
Can you hear me? Gahanir rests at the circle of spirits above, but it oozes nightmare into the Barrow Den. You must hurry before you succumb to the corruption.
Someone! Anyone! I can't escape these roofs!
I urge you to be cautious. You must not let the nightmare overcome you.
I don't know what's... I don't remember what I was doing.
I can feel the nightmare encroaching on your mind.
Okay.
Are you all right? I think you're past the worst of it.
I think we're okay.
You're nearly there. Just stay focused.
Nope. I messed up. Okay. No problem. We do it again. So, you can't get corrupted by the dream by stepping in the junk. I know that's where I messed up last time, and I did it again. Just like I said I would. Yes, I can hear you. Shut up. Okay, so, make sure you don't step in the red crap. As you can see, the waters are polluted.
Anyone! I can't escape these roofs!
Our friend is caught there, but I don't think we can help. So, and we don't have much time, so we're going to just get our booties out of here. Make sure you're not standing in that red junk. I think there's a mob there. There is. Kinda hoping.
I urge you to be cautious. You must not let the nightmare overcome you.
Okay. We're almost out. Stealth again. Okay. And this is obviously the Dream Grove still, but in the Emerald Dream. Make our way over here.
Take care.
Please help.
I can feel the
nightmare. I can't hold the corruption back much longer.
Okay. There's Gonir. The corrupted.
I would have surely been overwhelmed if you had not arrived.
Gonir.
Thank you. Let us reconvene in the physical world.
Okay.
By the ancients, you have it.
You have Gahanir.
So, you can see now, our item that we had was replaced with this, the Corrupted Gahanir Mother Tree item. It is item level 750, so for the rest of the quest, this is going to be in our hands.
We will protect the wild.
Delving into the dream with such darkness encroaching is no simple task. One few druids dare attempt. Oh, I see. But I'm afraid your journey is far from over.
The balance must be
restored. You found Lyessa in the dream, didn't you, Shondo? I heard you mutter her name in your slumber. Thank Alun, she is well. You must seek her out. I could sense her presence even now at the circle of spirits above. If ever there were one who could help us cleanse Gahanir, it is Lyessa.
Alun's light, Gahanir grows more corrupt with each passing moment. May your feet carry you swiftly.
Okay, let's head up and meet up with Lyessa. And keep it moving. I can't believe I failed it. Even after I said I'm not gonna fail it. Amazing. I'm the best. That was unfortunate. But just make sure when you're running through there, avoid the red crap on the ground. It's exactly what I did last time I did this. As I ran through the red crap. And I did it like 6 times. At least I learned quickly this one. Let's hop on a mount over to the Circle of the Spirits.
Gahanir will not last much longer. It must be cleansed.
All life is precious.
I don't know how much longer I would have lasted had you not
arrived.
We
must aid Bashana in cleansing the remaining nightmare. Gahanir's fate rests with Lyessa and this hero.
We must save the Mother Tree at all costs. I believe I know a way. The World Tree Nordrassil atop Mount Hyjal was born from an acorn of Gahanir. We can use the sacred water surrounding its roots to purify the corruption. If we take the Dreamway to Mount Hyjal's summit, we should have enough time to complete the cleansing ritual before Gahanir falls completely to the darkness. Use the Dreamway to travel to Mount Hyjal, then cleanse Gahanir in the sacred waters beneath Nordrassil. And you get the title, Guardian of Gahanir.
In Gahanir's name, may the ancients bless us all.
Okay, now we're going to be heading back to the dream.
Hamul Rune Totem led a small party to investigate Legion activity near Nordrassil not long ago. He may be able to aid you.
So this is the portal we're going to take to Hyjal. Let's go.
Once Gahanir is pure again, we can help Archdruid Great Elm cleanse any remaining nightmare at the Dream Grove.
And Hyjal's over this direction.
I only hope we are not too late to save Gahanir.
I too hope this. Let's get some of this junk off our bar before we go in. So we are going to do a little bit of healing, if I recall correctly. And I want to make sure our heals are on our bar correctly. I forgot to fix that up before we started the video, so I do apologize for that little delay.
Such devastation.
Thank the ancients you've come. The skies
so you talked
call out for aid.
They were too much.
May the wind gates of hell poured forth upon us. They were everywhere. Tend to the others first. Their wounds are more dire than my own.
Skylord, you must inform the Dream Grove. We will ensure no further life is lost this day. You must save our injured. I will prepare the cleansing ritual.
So, you just use your abilities. Cleanse Zentabra.
I feel my soul returning to Deloa.
We have to head over to Celestine of the Harvest.
Oh, my head. I feel dizzy.
And we're going to heal her up. Slowly but surely.
The well was nearly lost during the assault. But so long as a single drop remains, there is hope.
And of course, Archdruid Hamul Rune Totem. We're going to heal him up as well.
Thank you. We barely survived their last attack.
And this should do it. Boom.
The Legion has not forgotten their defeat here.
I am ready to begin the ritual.
So, now you can see we have kind of a party set together. When this starts, hopefully it works this time. The last time it didn't, I had to target them all singularly. Little raid UI is going to show up right along here with these people. So we'll be able to heal them up as we go through our little scenario. You can see we're probably going to be fighting some Legion here.
How may I help?
And let's get started. I am ready.
May Aviana's wind guide you.
I will prepare the well's waters for the cleansing.
You must protect me until the ritual is complete, or Gahanir will be lost.
Something ain't right. The spirits be crying out.
Always temper your strength with wisdom.
The Mother Tree's gifts are everywhere.
The gateway is activating! Tremble before me! I bring darkness to this world!
And there is Destromath.
If you keep us alive, we will buy you the time you need.
This is a little unfortunate. Apparently, we are going to be unable to see.
In Manawalt's name!
Okay, we can see. Oh, there we go. Okay, it all showed up. Perfect. This is what we were hoping for.
Your life slips away.
We want to make sure we're keeping all our party members at max health.
I can feel the well growing in strength. We must push forward.
Lambs to the slaughter! The demon's assault is relentless. I require aid. Tremble! You fail to amuse me.
This does get a little bit difficult. But hopefully.
You fail to amuse me.
The power grows with every moment. This day will be ours.
All shall burn.
Hopefully I do well enough.
Tremble!
The ritual is nearly complete.
The demon's assault is relentless. I require aid. Tremble! All shall burn. Your life slips away. The demon's assault is relentless. I require aid. Tremble! You fail lambs to the slaughter. Your life slips away.
Well, if you look. This gets super difficult.
Pitiful worms! What trickery is this?
Quickly, hero! Our work is nearly complete. You must give me the staff.
And we'll go click on her now.
Spirits of the forest, guardians of nature, hear our plea. On this day, the Mother Tree is reborn. Gahanir is whole once more!
So you can see we can call the Mother Tree. Oh, and we need to pick it up, right? Hello? Give me the staff. I forgot to do this part. There we go, we have Ghanir, the mother tree, and we've gained
use
our
use Ghanir to call upon the spirits of the forest to destroy this fiend!
Alright, now we're going to call upon the spirits of the forest.
I will destroy you!
And
your
there goes Destromath.
Will burn!
It is done. Let us all return to the Dream Grove and tell the others of our triumph.
Okay, and before we head back, I'm just going to show you a couple things.
We must stay behind for a time to aid Sky Lord Omneron's forces.
Here we go. This is Ghanir, the Mother Tree.
Thank you. Without you, we would have surely fallen.
No problem, anytime. So there's our weapon. There will be item-specific transmogs for this throughout Legion that you can obtain through various methods, and also you can transmog this to anything you want. So if you're not particularly happy with the way that the item looks, and you have a staff you like better, or pole arm or something that you like better, you can transmog it to that as well. We did get this ability, though. We have the Essence of Ghanir, a 1.5-minute cooldown instant cast, releasing the nature power within Ghanir to increase the frequency that all of your heal over time affects heal allies by 100% for 8 seconds. So, we'll put a couple hots on herself here. As you can see, if we pop that, you can see we're getting tons and tons of heals quickly. There's a little animation below us. Again, I'll look at this again later towards the end of the video. But that's the ability that we obtained with the weapon. So, pretty cool. If you did see, before we leave, I did die. The biggest problem I have with this particular scenario, and I am going to write a suggestion ticket after I'm done with this video. You can see, we do get aggro a lot, and it's not it's not very easy to keep all of these people up. Now, I don't play Resto very often. I haven't played a healer since Burning Crusade, so... Well, I have played a healer since Burning, but I haven't played one in, like, raids and stuff like that since the Burning Crusade, so... it was a little difficult to maintain keeping them up, keeping me up. So you can see I am not the greatest. You'd probably be a lot better than me. Again, gear may have played a factor. I've done this twice at 680, and I think I've died twice on that. So I do apologize that you had to watch that. You might have been cringing at my healing ability, but, I'm trying to learn as I go here. Okay, let's head over to the Circle of Spirits
again. Were it not for this
again.
Hero's actions, we would have all perished atop Mount Hyjal. All life.
Both Ghanir and Nordrasil would have been destroyed by the Legion.
We all owe you a great deal for your heroism. I owe you a great deal. I suspect this war is far from over.
And for centuries I have watched over Ghanir. Today it nearly fell to the corruption I swore to fight. It is time for another to take my place. Therefore, I hereby pass along my station to this hero. A true protector of life. A true guardian of the dream. Thank you again, Shando. I will remain here, in the Dream Grove, if you ever have need of my guidance.
Cool.
Nature's gifts.
Your weapon is
everywhere.
Ancient and powerful, but it holds the potential to be so much more. Take this seed. It is all that remains of a forest that grew tall when the world was young. Plant it within the grove to the west and allow it to take root. With its power, both it and your weapon will be far more than they are alone.
May your
The seed will need plenty of air and water. Look for an ideal spot on the hill behind us.
So we head right up here, up the hill. There's a little outline I had to click on. You can see it right there. Should go ahead and click on this.
Good. This seed holds magic from when the world was young. This will prove very useful.
Excellent. There's no time to waste. These weapons were crafted with ancient magic. The true power of your artifact lies in its ability to grow in strength. The more you use it, the stronger it will become. Now that you have attuned your weapon to the Seed of Ages, you can use its magic to unlock additional attributes in your weapon. Use it now and unlock your weapon's potential. We'll accept
Walk,
that.
The magic of your weapon runs deep. Its power will grow with you.
So we go ahead and click on that. As you can see, it brings up the UI for our weapon. You can see that's what happens with the Seed of Ages. Kind of grows a little pool there, and our weapon sits atop. As you can see, there is the essence of Gahanir, the ability we gained by obtaining the item. And here is the first trait that's available to us. It's called Nature's Vigor. This is a one rank passive, increasing the healing of our rejuvenation by 15%. You can see it costs 100 artifact power, which we are given by completing the quest line and also for the purposes of this tutorial. So there we go. Let's go ahead and put that in. And that will open up the rest of the item's traits. As you can see, there are three golden portraited traits. These are the most important and powerful ones that do something in special in particular. So you can see there are three directions that we can go from Nature's Vigor, three lines that we can start progressing. So make sure you're picking which one of these golden portraited traits you're most interested in going after. There is a way to respec in this expansion for your weapon. There's no real need to, because eventually you will have all of these filled up. You'll have points in all of these, but just pick which golden portraited trait is going to help you the most. So if you're, you know, take a look through all of these before you start putting points in. But you can see, we'll start down here. Infusion of Nature is a 3-rank passive. This reduces the mana cost of wild growth by 2%, and it would be obviously 6% at max. It costs 300 artifact power for the first rank, and depending on how Blizzard goes at the beginning of the expansion, it may cost 300 artifact power for each rank, or it may increase for each rank. So it may be 300, 400, 500, or something along those lines. I don't know in particular, but just keep that in mind. It may stay static for, you know, this one and then go up for the next, or it may be each rank will cost a little bit more. But I'm only going to read what they have here. I'm not going to read it off as if it were if you had three ranks in it. So you can do the simple math in your head if you're interested in knowing what the percentages would be at max rank. Here we have Persistence, a 3-rank passive, increasing the duration of Moonfire, Rejuve, and Sunfire by 1 second. Knowledge of the Ancients, a 3-rank passive, increasing mana regen by 2%. Power of the Arc Druid is our first major trait here, 1-rank passive. Wild Growth has a 25% chance to cause your next rejuvenation or regrowth to also apply two additional allies within 15 yards of the target. Here we have Seeds of the World Tree. This is a 3-rank passive. Living Seed heals for an additional 10% of the initial heal which planted it. Here we have Natural Mending, increasing healing done by Swift Mend by 10%. Grove Walker, 3-rank passive, increasing all healing over time you do by 1%. Blooms of Gahanir, a 1-rank passive, increases the bloom healing of Life Bloom by 50%. We looked at this one. Here we have Mark of Shifting, a 1-rank passive. While in Travel Form, Cat Form, Moonkin, or Bear Form, you heal for 1% of your maximum health every 3 seconds. We looked at that. We have Nature's Essence, a 1-rank passive. Wild Growth instantly heals its targets for 6,811. We have Essence of Noradrasil, a 3-rank passive, increasing healing done by Efflorescence by 5%. And our second major passive, Dreamwalker. This is a 1-rank. Wild Growth has a 50% chance to momentarily shift your mind into the Emerald Dream, instantly healing all allies affected by your rejuvenation by 17,028. Here we have Armor of the Ancients, a 3-rank passive. Ironbark reduces all damage taken by the target by an additional 2%. We looked at that. So we have Blessing of the World Tree, a 3-rank passive, increasing healing done by Healing Touch, and initial healing done by Regrowth by 3%. And of course, our final trait, another one of the golden passives, Tranquil Mind. This increases healing done by Tranquility by 20%, and you can now cast Tranquility while moving. So that's a very good one. That's a very strong AoE healing talent. All right, we've looked at all of our traits, all of our abilities that we have here to increase our power. And you can see here we have 3 relic slots. One is locked. You cannot open this one up until you finish your Druid class Order Hall campaign, which can take you well into 110, so don't worry too much about this one right now. You'll worry about this a little later on. These two, though, you have available to you as soon as you equip the weapon, and you will get relics to put in these slots through quests and even dungeons. So while you're leveling up, if you hop into a dungeon queue and you get in, or you're just going to power level through quests, you'll get stuff to put in here. These will add passive item levels to your staff, so you'll get passive item levels through this. You will also gain passive ranks for these. So let's say, for instance, you have 3 of 3 Essence of Nordrassil, which would give you 15% increased healing by Efflorescence, and this gives an extra 2 ranks. You would have 5 of 3 in Essence of Nordrassil, and that would increase this to 25%. And that's just an example. I believe it can be any of these, and I'm not sure, but I think this one right here might affect your golden portrait traits. I haven't gotten that far myself, but I believe that that's what that slot is for. So keep that in mind. One more thing about the artifacts relics. Make sure when you are putting a new relic in, it won't really affect you while you're questing on your way to 110, but once you're 110, make sure when you're putting a new relic into the slot that you're okay with getting rid of the one that's inside, because you can't take them out. There's no way to take the relics out, and Blizzard has stated that they don't have any intention to allow us to do so. So make sure when you're putting one over top, you're okay with the one inside being destroyed. You're not just trying to test something out. Just keep that in mind. Like I said, when you're questing, it won't really make a big deal, because you'll probably have, an extra 10 item levels, and that's more important than, one point here or one point there in your traits. But when you're at 110, really make sure that you're keeping an eye on that. As you can see, we have a 1 in our portrait up here for Ghanir, the Mother Tree. Every rank that we purchase, every trait purchased, up to 34 traits, will give you a passive amount of stamina and damage dealt. As you can see, it's 0.75% per trait and 1% in your damage dealt per trait. So when you're putting points all around, you'll get a bunch of passive stamina and damage, and this is you'll get stamina and damage for both healers and tanks. For DPS specs, you only get stamina. So keep that in mind. You get a little bit of extra damage dealt as you're putting points in when you're leveling up as a healer. I want to show you, you're able to open up that UI by shift right clicking in your inventory or in your character pane to be able to look at all this stuff. You are able to put relics into the slots anywhere in the world, but you are unable to put in artifact power anywhere except for here at the Seat of Ages in the Dream Grove. So keep that in mind. I also wouldn't suggest coming back here every time you just barely get enough points to put one point into something, unless it's for one of these golden portraited traits. At 110, it gets much more expensive, so then I would suggest, you can just teleport back here, put a point in, and hearth back and go back to what you were doing. But while you're doing your leveling from 100 to 110, it's not really necessary. You're going to be coming back here all the time. They're going to be sending you back here kind of as a tutorial to show you this new thing or that new thing, or to send you off to the next zone. So wait till you finish a zone, come back here, throw all your points in, and then move back out into the world. Okay, we've taken a look at our artifact weapon.
We are nature's
excellent
guardians.
Excellent. As your weapon grows in power, you can return here and unleash its true potential. Now you are more powerful than ever. Truly are a druid without equal. I sense that Malfurion has arrived. He will certainly want to know of your accomplishments. But first, please walk with me a moment.
Go with Cenarius's blessing. I admit I had my doubts. I never believed I'd see anyone capable of obtaining the weapon you now hold. It's rare that I'm proven wrong. In this case, I'm pleased that I was.
You are already more powerful than many senior members of our order. Still, I sense that even more growth is yet to come. In time, your powers will reach heights undreamed of. Shando Malfurion awaits. Go. Be recognized for your accomplishments.
I must protect the wild. Nature stands with
your
you.
Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Time and again, you have proven yourself to be one of our finest. The strength, ferocity, and nobility you have shown are without peer. It is time you were honored accordingly. It is my honor to welcome you as an Arc-Druid of the Cenarian Circle. May all the creatures of the wild celebrate your ascension.
Okay, now we are an Arc-Druid.
Greetings, friend.
Congratulations, Arc-Druid. We will be counting on you in the days ahead. It is time that we turn our attention to the matters in the Broken Isles. Skylord Omniron has gathered information on events from all over the Isles. If we are presented with any opportunity to strike against the Legion, he will know of it. Go and see if he has anything
May
available.
May nature, I place you in charge of the Grove's efforts here. I must travel to the south and seek out Cenarius. Only with his aid will we stop the Legion. Elune, guide your path.
Okay, and then Malfurion turns into a bird and slowly, slowly flies away. He's on his way. You'll see him eventually in... Well, you're going to see him again. Just, you know that. You'll see him at some point. Okay, so here's Skylord Omniron.
Even the
greetings, Arc-Druid. The threats we face are numerous. We must act quickly. The Burning Legion threatens the life of Azeroth, but the Nightmare threatens its very soul. We must remove both threats if our world is to survive. This map will allow us to track the developments all across the Broken Isles and respond to threats as they arise. Our forces are limited now, so we should focus our efforts where they will be the most effective. Once you've taken a look, you should choose where we shall begin.
We must soar above.
So you click
calamity.
On this. And it brings up your scouting map UI. This here in the middle is Suramar. This is a 110 only zone, so don't worry about this or these areas down here. But this is Stormheim, High Mountain, Val'Shirah, and Asuna. These are the four zones you'll be questing through on your way to 110. It does not matter where you start or where you finish. The zones will level with you. So as soon as you hit 101, every mob in every zone is 101 as well. And that will happen all the way up until 110. So keep that in mind. It doesn't matter. You know, just pick which zone you think is the coolest. If you're a lore nerd, you know, pick the one that you think has the coolest lore, like I will. Otherwise, just, you know, start on one end and make your way to the other. It doesn't matter. If you are leveling with someone, you might be asking, well, if I'm 101 and they're 100, and we, you know, catch up and they're still not 101, will we be able to quest together? Absolutely. As long as you're in the same phase, it doesn't matter the level difference. It's a static difficulty all the way through to 110, where the difficulty becomes a little bit more, and has a little bit more of an extreme jump. But, you know, when you're 101 and they're 100, you see the same mob. You'll just see it as a different level, but it takes the same amount of hits pretty much all the way up through 110 to be able to kill a mob. And 110, everything kind of changes up. So it's a pretty cool, it sounds a little wonky, but it actually works out really well. So. But for the purposes of this video, I'm going to pick Stormheim just to progress the story. Eventually, you'll be sent back here. You know, let's say you do pick Stormheim, you finish up the zone, you're sent back here, then you'll be prompted to pick your next zone. And you can, and that'll happen all the way through. So, you know, now I'm going to go to High Mountain, boom. Go out, finish High Mountain, come back, Val'Shirah, blah, blah, blah. Okay, I clicked on that.
Aviana Blessing.
Yes, I agree. That is a good place to focus our initial efforts. As new threats arise, I will bring them to your attention. Elune, guide your path, Arc-Druid.
If we fall, we fall together.
Okay, now that we've talked to him, he's actually going to have a little speech with us here, but I can tell you basically what he's going to say. He's going to say, the Kirin Tor have opened a portal for us to Dalaran. It is right up the hill, and here it is. This is our way back to Dalaran, besides using our Hearthstone or our Dalaran Hearthstone. So if you just want to take the portal and save your Hearthstone, you can do that. Jump into Portal Dalaran. There is also another way to get here besides using our portal, our Dreamwalk portal. Just pick up this Flight Master's flight point, and you'll be able to fly here from Dalaran. So, you know, if for some reason you just want to fly here, you just want to take a break, or you have to get up and get something to drink, and you don't want to sit AFK, you can just put yourself on the flight path, and you'll end up here. Okay? Or if you're, you know, in Val Shirao, which is the zone that this area's in. Oh, that doesn't work. If you're, you know, right here in Val Shirao doing a quest, you can just fly over. Okay, a couple things I want to talk about before we're done with talking about the class hall. There are some things I'm not going to talk about because they are lore heavy. As you can see, there's like a quest giver over here. I'm not going to talk about any of that, but I'm going to talk about a couple of things. First and foremost, get this out of the way. There is a vendor in this building here. I'll show you where I'm at inside this tree right here. There's a vendor here.
Hello.
Click on this vendor and she has a set available to us. This is the Dream Grove set. We'll click on it so you can get an idea of what it looks like. There's the models for this. It's not the best looking set, but if you are a casual player or someone who plays a druid as an alt and doesn't have much time to, you know, do dailies, the world quests every day, or run dungeons on this character to be able to get yourself some gear, this is not a bad set to obtain. This set does require you to be 110. And it will cost, at this moment, 500 gold, but it has requirements beyond 110 for some of the pieces, being 6 champions for your order hall, being honored with the Night Fallen, and all the way up to earning 100,000 artifact power, and being exalted with the Night Fallen. So you can kind of get this set if you're a casual player, or if you're playing this as an alt, when you don't have time, you know, run raids or run LFR or anything like that, you can just pick these pieces up, and it'll give you a nice little set bonus. I'm not going to read them off, so if you want to pause the video and look at them here, you can go ahead and do that. But they can also be upgraded. As you can see, some of the item levels for these pieces are 810, 820, and 830, and of course, these two epic pieces are 840. You can see here, for order resources, you can buy these armor kits, which are the same thing as the upgrade tokens you could buy in Warlords of Draenor from from people with professions, corresponding professions. You can go ahead and buy those. Now for order resources and upgrade those pieces all the way to 840 and have yourself a nice little set. So if you don't have a lot of time to do raiding and stuff like that, you could still end up with a nice set. And then, you know, do world quests at your own pace, maybe run a raid here and there.
Be careful.
Do mythic dungeons and you'll get yourself you'll have yourself a decent set. You won't be like you're not able to get anything. And then there's some of these flavor items that you can buy. They're 50 gold right now. They may be you know, that may change.
Farewell.
But let's buy one, I'll show you. You get Treant form. We'll learn that. These are kind of some of the old minor glyphs and stuff like that. So now we got Treant form. Boom. And I think we can heal from it, so if you want to go back and have the old tree form from, what was it, Burning Crusade, there we go. You can be a tree. Pretty cool. Okay, let's hop on our mount before I go over and the talents and our abilities that we have. Baseline, we're going to talk about one more thing. And you can see at the top we have this little bar that shows up every time we come to our class hall, and it shows our order resources. These are the exact same thing as your garrison resources that we have in Warlords of Draenor. Don't be afraid, though. It's not like it was in Warlords, where you're spending most of your time sending off missions. There will be missions that we will use these resources for, but they're usually for our class order hall campaign to extend that lore quest line. Also, you'll get some artifact power from some of the missions. You can get gold from some of the missions, and I believe you can also get order resources unless they change that. It's been a while since I've been playing on a 110 character, so you can get those, you know, little things going. You will also use those order resources to recruit troops. These are kind of like minion mobs from Warcraft 3. So you will be able to, I believe, now you don't take my word for this because obviously I haven't leveled up, but you might be able to, for instance, recruit Treants, the Dryads, and things like that to send out on missions. They each have their own increased success chance on those missions, and they have certain amounts of uses. So you might have, like, let's say you get some Treants, and they have three uses, so you can use them on three missions, as long as you've recruited them. So keep that in mind, and you will be taken through a tutorial at some point while you're leveling. When you'll be sent here, and they'll tell you to, you know, recruit them. You also have champions that you'll have for your order hall. Some are major lore characters, some are new characters you might not have ever heard of, but those characters will be available to you to send out on missions. Let's just say, for instance, one of them might be Lyessa, that woman that we had helping us through our quest line. One may be her, and what you would be able to do is you'll have a big UI, just like we had in Warlords of Draenor, to put up people on our missions, and we'll also have a little spot down here at the bottom for a bodyguard. I don't know in particular who those bodyguards are for the Druid class hall, but make sure you're bringing one with you once you have the opportunity to. They are very strong. Some of them even stick with you in the world, open world, permanently. They'll just keep coming as long as you keep them in the bodyguard tab and you don't send them out on missions. They'll just keep coming out with you, which is absolutely amazing. Because they really deal a little bit of extra damage. Some of them might heal as well, but they usually have really cool abilities, and they're, from what I've seen, they're normally pretty major lore characters, so it gives it a nice feel, kind of like Diablo 3's follower system, or Diablo 2's follower system, where you would have one with you in the open world at all times, but they will not follow you into raids or dungeons, so keep that in mind. But when you have the opportunity, make sure you're putting one in the bodyguard slot and bringing them with you. You will also use these order resources for research upgrades in the order hall. Now, I can't show you the UI for this, but I can tell you a little bit about it. Those research upgrades, there are six tiers. In five of the tiers, you will have one of two choices to make, and they will cost order resources and take a certain amount of time to research. The first one being 2 hour research time, and I think 50 order resources. And when you start that one, you'll have the choice between, I believe, a 20% increased mission success chance per day on your first mission of the day, and I think the other is a chance for when you're doing your quests and you get a piece of gear for that to upgrade, you know, a green to a blue to an epic. You'll have the choice between those two, and you'll move down, and the time will get increased on the research, and the order resources will increase. At 110, eventually, it'll go to 7 days, 10 days, 12 days, and the final in the 6th tier will take 14 days. So keep in mind, this will take probably, can take almost 2 months of time to be able to finish up your upgrades for your class order hall. And depending, of course, upon how much you play, and they do cost quite a bit of resources as you go down the line. But some of those more important choices are to get one of your three bonus seals per week through your class order hall for free. So this is an extra roll on a boss in a raid, which can be very useful. And then the final tier upgrade, which is the absolute most important, is for you to be able to wear two of these, which you can find in your adventure guide under loot. These are the Restoration Druid legendary items that are world drops. So you might say, why are these so important? Well, you can wear one as soon as you hit level 110. So if you get one to drop, you can put it on right away. But you can wear two of these, and the reason these are the best is because they are item level 895 legendary items. You can see the stats on them are absolutely amazing, and they each have their own equip bonus, some of which might increase your healing, some might increase like your defensive abilities, some might increase your utility, some might even increase damage. So these are really useful. I don't think there's any damage on the healer ones, but for most of the other classes, either damage, utility, or defensive ability. So, but this will be healing instead of damage. So let's just take a look at a couple of the equip bonuses so you can get an idea of why these are so useful. Here's Amanthul's Wisdom. Rejuvenation cast on a full health target will reset to its full duration each time it heals the target until the target takes damage or 10 seconds has elapsed. Here is Eco Wraith, Creator of Worlds. Ooh, excuse me. A little bit of indigestion there. Increase the effect of Astral Influence, Feline Swiftness, Thick Hide, and Isera's Gift by 50%. And those are all passive abilities, so that can be very useful. That's kind of a utility one. And here's one. Swift Mend extends the duration of your heal over time effects on the target by 10 seconds. So you can see wearing two of these will make you significantly better as a healer, depending on which ones you get, of course. There are RNG world drops, but there Blizzard has said there are like kind of safety nets in place. The longer that you go without getting one, the higher the chance that you will eventually get one is. So keep that in mind. Don't be too discouraged if you don't get one. As soon as you hit 110 and do your first world quest, you may get one shortly. Okay, now that we've looked at that, let's take a look at our talents that are available to us as a Restoration Druid. In the 15 tier, we have Prosperity. This is a passive where Swift Mend will have 2 charges, and its cooldown is reduced by 5 seconds. We have Cenarian Ward, 2,944 mana cost, instant cast on a 30-second cooldown. It protects a friendly target for 30 seconds. Any damage taken will consume the ward and heal the target for 63,290 over 8 seconds. And finally, Abundance, a passive. For each rejuvenation you have active, the cast time of Healing Touch is reduced by 10%, and the critical effect chance of regrowth is increased by 10%. Oh, before I go any further, this is not indicative of the best spec, by any means. I just kind of picked as I went. I looked through them all, got an idea of what they did, and just picked what I would probably go with if I was leveling. So, you know, this is not by any means min-maxed. This is not, I did not look up, you know, a talent spec on, you know, a beta form somewhere. This is just, I just picked this, all this. In the 30 tier, we have Renewal. This is an instant cast on a 2-minute cooldown. Instantly heals you for 30% of your maximum health. This is usable in all shapeshift forms. We have Displacer Beast, an instant cast, 30-second cooldown. Teleports you up to 25 yards forward, activating cat form and increasing your movement speed by 50% for 4 seconds. And finally, Wild Charge, which is an instant cast with a 15-second cooldown. If you were non-shapeshifted, you would fly to an ally's position. In bear form, this is basically Warrior Charge. Cat form, you would leap behind an enemy, dazing them. In Moonkin form, you would jump backwards, like kind of like disengage. If you were in travel form, you would leap forward 20 yards, and if you were in aquatic form, you would just swim faster. In the 45 tier, we have Balance Affinity. This gives you the passive Astral Influence, which increases the range of your abilities by 5 yards, and you would gain Moonkin form, Star Surge, and Lunar Strike. So you would have, you'd be able to kind of deal spell damage a little bit better. Then we have Feral Affinity. You would gain the passive Feral Feline Swiftness, increasing your movement speed by 15%, and you would learn Shred, Rake, Rip, Ferocious Bite, and Swipe, and your energy regen would be increased by 35%. And finally, Guardian Affinity. You would gain Thick Hide, reducing all damage taken by 10%, and would learn the abilities Mangle, Thrash, Iron Fur, which is your damage reduction ability, and Frenzy Regen, which is your healing ability. In the 60 tier, we have Mighty Bash. This is an instant cast on a 50-second cooldown. Invokes the spirit of Ursoc to stun the target for 5 seconds. Usable in all shapeshift forms. We have Mass Entanglement, an instant cast with a 30-second cooldown, which roots the target in place for 20 seconds and spreads to additional nearby enemies. Damage may interrupt the effect, and is usable in all shapeshift forms. And finally, Typhoon, an instant cast with a 30-second cooldown, striking targets within 20 yards in front of you with a violent typhoon, knocking them back and dazing them for 6 seconds, and is, again, usable in all shapeshift forms. In the 75 tier, we have Soul of the Forest. When you cast Swift Mend, you gain Soul of the Forest, increasing the healing of your next regrowth or rejuve by 200%, or increasing the healing of your next wild growth by 75%. Then we have Incarnation, Tree of Life, which I forgot to use while we were doing our quest when I was about to die. This is an instant cast 3-minute cooldown. It shapeshifts into the Tree of Life, increasing healing done by 15%, increasing armor by 120%, and granting protection for polymorph effects. Functionality of rejuve, wild growth, regrowth, and and Tangling Roots is enhanced. This lasts 30 seconds, and you may shapeshift in and out of this form for its duration. So if you activate it and you go, oh, I need to switch over to Moonkin form and deal a little damage for a few seconds, and then you switch back, you'll still have the effects of Tree of Life. And finally, Cultivation, a passive where when Rejuve heals a target below 60% health, it applies Cultivation to the target, healing them for 8,631 over 6 seconds. In the 90 tier, we have Spring Blossoms, a passive where each target healed by Efflorescence is healed for an additional 4,086 over 6 seconds. Inner Peace, a passive which reduces the cooldown of Tranquility by 60 seconds. And Germination, a passive where you can apply Rejuve twice to the same target. And I forgot I had that, so bad on me. In the 100 tier, we have Moment of Clarity, a passive where an omen of clarity now affects the next three regrowths. We have Stone Bark, passive which reduces the cooldown of Iron Bark by 30 seconds and increases its healing from your heal overtime effects by 20%. And finally, Flourish, an instant cast on a 1-minute cooldown, extending the duration of all your heal overtime effects on friendly targets within 60 yards by 6 seconds. So if you got a whole bunch of rejuves on targets or wild growths and stuff, and suddenly, oops, you know, there's an AoE attack coming in from a raid boss, and you need to keep everybody up and Tranquility is on cooldown, you know, cast Flourish, get that shit back up, maybe pop Essence of Ghanir right afterwards. Okay, so we've looked at our talents. Again, this is not indicative of the best spec whatsoever. But I'll show you some of the passive abilities that we have. Of course, we do have Bear Form, Cat Form, Travel Form, and we obviously have Moonkin and Treant Form. I showed you why we have those. But I have Prowl on the bar just in case we get into a sticky situation, and we do have Dash to go along with our Cat Form. Bear Form doesn't really have anything in it right now. I didn't put any of the... I don't think we even have any of the abilities for Bear Form, do we? Let me look through here. No, we have the form so that we can jump into it and kind of, we can growl, we can go into bear form and growl at people. So that's cool. And you can moonfire while you're in bear form, so. Okay. But we have Innervate. This is an instant cast, 3-minute cooldown. This will infuse a friendly healer with energy, allowing them to cast spells without spending mana for 10 seconds. Let's take a look. This is what that will look like. And of course, you keep an eye on the mana bar there in the corner. Cast Regrowth a few more times, and no mana was used, except for right there because the effect wore off. So you get an idea of what happens there. We have Life Bloom, 3840 mana cost, heals the target for 26,990 over 15 seconds. When Life Bloom expires or is dispelled, the target is instantly healed for 17,028, and you can have a limit of one of your Life Blooms on the target at a time. These are our healing dummies. I want to point out, we do have healing and tanking dummies in this expansion. There's a tanking dummy. You don't want to hit him. He hits back. Just keep that in mind. I made that mistake on a tank. I think it was my paladin tank I made a video for. I hit the training dummy. He punched me in the face, and I died because he's level 114 or some shit. So here's our training dummy. We can pop a heal on him. Life Bloom doesn't really have much of an animation. That's the cast right there. As you can see, he's getting healed up. We have Iron Bark. This is a instant cast 1.5-minute cooldown. The target skin becomes as tough as iron wood, reducing all damage taken by 20% for 12 seconds. I'll cast that on myself. This is what Iron Bark looks like now. It's got a nice animation. The person with it will always know they have it, unless, of course, there's 60 things happening around you, but you get an idea. Especially in PvP, you'll have an idea if somebody has it on them. Here's Rejuve. This cost 3,200 mana. Is an instant cast and will heal for 29,515 over 15 seconds. That is the animation there for Rejuve. As you can see, giving them a little bit of heals. We have Bark Skin. This is instant cast, 1-minute cooldown. Your skin becomes as tough as bark, reducing all damage you take by 20% and preventing damage from delaying your spell casts. Last 12 seconds. You can also use this while stunned, frozen, incapacitated, feared, or asleep, and in all shapes.